do. You get the days off. You want, you get
two
a run.
Two dimes, three tokens, three nickels and a coat.
You get the hours, you can't have everything.
Thanks, Bill.
And one token. Oh. He wants all the money back again.
I have been driving the bus approximately 26 years. I've been with the company 26 years. And, I remember in the old streetcar days when the war was on, there was a young girl used to get on. Of course, the streetcars were terribly crowded in those days, and there was one girl who used to get on, and she was flirting with another young boy who was always on this particular, used to get on a few blocks behind. He said, let me do it right. Do you know this lady's name? So I said, no, I don't know, but I'll find out her name for you. And then I asked her what her name was, and I introduced them, made it formal. And I got an invitation to their wedding about 4 or 5 months afterwards. A lot of people don't ask the question in the right manner. Consequently, the bus driver often gets blamed for giving the wrong information. The worst offenders are the ladies, I'm afraid. I find men very businesslike.
They didn't call me fleet foot for nothing.
Oh, you're under more than I can. This is an exceptionally good run. There's a lot of young people who live out on the island here. Now, of course, I've known a lot of these people. Why I like this run, take a fancy to, I've worked on the island quite a bit, and some of these people, girls who I take home in the evening, I used to take them to school when they were 4 or 5 years of age. Now they're young married ladies. It's very attractive to them. Thank you.
please.
I pull up to the zone before I load.
What bus do I take to get to Garden City in Alexandria?
This one right here. Check with this. Oh, number three road.
I haven't the actual evidence, but when I got to the end of the line, I found at the back of the bus there was a Woodward's dress box with an old dirty dress in it. So the woman must have changed her dress in the bus. What else could she have done? It was a new box with tissue paper in it and a dirty old dress in it on the floor. Liking people, you have to like people on this job, or you'll get in your hair if you don't.
30?
Driver that you meet is a person who you might cause him some disturbance down the street, something that you might not even know. You might put your flasher on and pull out and cut him off, and he will wait until his turn comes to get in front of you, and he'll stop suddenly and try to aggravate you in some way. Drive maybe probably at 5 miles an hour ahead of you for a radius of 6 or 7 blocks, makes it more simple. There's not very much you can do, just you count slowly to yourself, 20, 30, 40, 50, and hopefully pulls away. I generally pull into the curb as though, even if there's nobody at the bus stop, I sometimes pull into the curb and give it.
Going to be staying here.
About 2 minutes.
I made the wrong, got on the wrong bus, and I have to go all the way back.
Thank you.
Do I get this for Buena Vista?
No, ma'am. Yeah, I'd get an Oak Street from here and ask the driver. He'll put you on the Burnaby bus. Yes.
Oak Street goes out to Burnaby.
Yes. Front door, please. Front door, please. Good night. Good night. They empty the fur box here, empty the face of the fur box, you see. At the end of
some people might say to you, why or how on earth have you been driving a bus for 20 years? Don't you get sick of it? Well, yes, you do get sick of it, but you have to, I think you get sick of everything that you do. I don't, it doesn't matter. I think a doctor, lawyer, or doctors is a very pressing job. You must get terribly fed up from time to time. But I think if you like what you're doing, I think you're happiest as you like. I like what I'm doing. I like bus driving. And I think it makes for a happy life to enjoy what you're doing.